Hello and welcome to the online classes. I am Adela Samuel from the Department of Accounting and Finance, St. Anne's Arts and Science College, Madhavaram. I will be handling the marketing subject for you for this semester. Hope you enjoy the videos that we put up for your benefit through the Google Classrooms. So let's start today's class with Unit 1, Introduction to Marketing. Before we enter into the concept of marketing, let us first see the concept of the term market. The term market is derived from the Latin word mercatus, which means to trade. So the term market also has many meanings to it. So the following meanings we can add to the term market. First one is, it is a place. The place, the marketplace. So it refers to the place in which marketing takes place. Second thing is, it's an assembly of buyers and sellers, where the buyers and the sellers put up their shops and they try to sell their things, and buyers come there to buy their things. So such a place can also be termed as a market. Third one, it's the area of operation, the entire area where marketing takes place, we can refer to it as market. The fourth concept that we add to the term market is the act. Just the act of buying and selling a product, we can term it as market. So it's not just the place or the place where buyers and sellers meet and an operation takes place. It also refers to just the act of buying and selling things. Buying and selling things can also mean market. Fifth concept is organization. So market can also refer to the organization which is going to deal with marketing. Okay. So when an organization is involved in buying and selling things, or when an organization is involved in producing a product and trying to take it to the ultimate customers, wherein the customers buy the product, that organization can also be called as a market. So the term market does not only mean to trade, but it also has the meanings of a place, an assembly, an area of operation, an act, or an organization. So let's look into the definition of the term market. Market is defined by Professor Juvons. He says, markets include both place and region in which buyers and sellers are in free competition with one another. So according to him, he talks from the point of view of the place or the area in which the buyers and sellers are competing with each other to buy things. So when we say competition, it refers to the communication or the interaction that both of them have, or the bargain that both of them do to buy and sell certain products. So he talks from the point of view of area. According to Clark in the second definition, they say, markets is an area in which the forces leading to exchange of title to particular product operate, and towards which and from which the actual goods tend to travel. So here, market is explained from the point of view of exchange of title. So the title is shifted from the seller to the buyer once the product is sold to the buyer. So more than the area, it refers to the title, or the exchange of title that happens between the seller and the buyer. So they say at the end of the definition, towards which and from which the actual goods tend to travel. So it travels from the seller to the actual buyer. So the title travels from the seller to the buyer. The products also travel from the seller to the buyer. So these are the two definitions that is given by authors. Now what we are going to see is the meaning of the term market from various point of views. So first off, we'll start off with the economic point of view. So from an economic point of view, market refers to the demand for a commodity. The demand for a particular product by a group of people known as the target audience is the market for a product. So thus, the demand is referred to as the market according to the economic point of view. Okay, I can explain this target audience. For example, if you say
you're going to buy some product like Horlicks or a Complan. So the target audience might be mothers who are buying these Horlicks or Complan for their children. So the mothers will be called as the target audience. So this target audience will refer to as the demand that is present in the market for a particular product. So this target audience or the demand that the target audience have will refer to the market that is present for a particular product. So demand means the market. So according to economic point of view, we can say the number of people who are demanding for a product will refer to the market of a particular product.
Okay, so the second point of view is from a management's point of view. So from a management point of view, we can say that market is a social institution that performs the work of the middlemen or helps in the process of buying and selling. Hence, market is an institution. So when we say it is an institution, this institution does the job of producing the product, traveling the product from one point to another point, transporting the product from the producer to the wholesaler, to the retailer, and then finally reach this the customer who is going to actually use the product. Okay, so the institution here will act like a middleman, or the middleman will help in the process of taking the product from the producer or the manufacturer to the ultimate customer who is going to use the product. So the institution that is present or a company that is present which does all this can also be referred to as a market. So from a management's point of view, we can say that an institution which is dealing with the process of marketing a particular product is called as the market. So the third point of view is from a societal point of view or from the society's point of view. So when we say society's point of view, we refer to market is considered as the point where need arises. And market is also the place where this need is satisfied. Okay, so when we say need, we have basic needs like food, water, clothing, and shelter. Okay, but how does this need become want for us? It's when the market advertises products which will attract the need that we have, and we tend to buy products to satisfy that need. For example, if we are hungry, that is a basic need. But when we say we want only pizza, or we want a particular shop's burger, or we want Saravana Bhavan's masala dosa, or we want Anand Bhavan's sweet, then it becomes a want, and that is what the market tends to do to our needs. Okay, so market is considered as the point where our need is aroused. Or if you take the example of clothing, clothing is basic need that we have just to cover ourselves. If we want to buy clothing in a particular style that is advertised from a particular shop or a particular brand that we want to wear, that is what market does. From a society's point of view, they arouse our needs. Market also is a place where the need is satisfied. So in order to satisfy this need, which is aroused by the market themselves, we tend to go to the market and buy products that will satisfy our need. So from a society's point of view, we can say that market is a point where the need arises, and market is the place where our needs are also going to be satisfied. So to sum it up, the definition of market given by the American Marketing Association, the AMA, which is a usually asked 2-mark question, and this is a very important definition which we need to remember. So what this AMA states is, market is defined as the place or area where buyers and sellers function to perform business activities which directs the flow of goods and service from the producer to the customer or the user. So three parts are there to this definition. They say it's the place or the area where the buyers and the sellers are functioning. So the buyers and the sellers function is to buy and sell things.
to perform business activities which direct the flow of goods and services. So this process of marketing takes place where the flow of goods from one person to another person is directed. That's the second part of the definition. And the third part, it says from the producer to the ultimate customer. So the buyers and sellers perform their job or their act where the goods are flowing from one point to another point, which is the producer to the ultimate customer or the user. So this is the basic definition given by AMA or the American Marketing Association.
I hope you have understood what we have studied in today's class. We had just started off with the introductory part of the concept of market. So we've learned what is the meaning of the term market. We have seen a few definitions from different authors. We've also covered the meaning of market from various point of views.
So I hope you've enjoyed today's video and you've understood clearly what we had done today. We will continue the other topics in the next class. Thank you.